हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी, वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कंसेप्ट ऑफ बबल सॉर्ट। व्हाट इज बबल सॉर्ट? इट्स इंट्रोडक्शन, इट्स सॉल्व्ड एग्जांपल्स एंड इट्स अल्गोरिदम विथ ड्राई रन। ऑल दीज थिंग्स आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज। बिफोर मूविंग टू द कंटेंट, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल टेक टॉक्स एंड कीप द बेल रिंगिंग। नाउ द करंट वीडियो इज एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ बबल सॉर्ट। वॉट इज बबल सॉर्ट? दैट आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू इन दिस वीडियो सेशन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ इट्स इंट्रोडक्शन। सो ऑल ऑफ यू मस्ट बी नोइंग दैट bubble sort is the simplest method of sorting. It is a very simple one, and usually the concept of sorting is started with the bubble sort. To know, to understand, to learn the sorting techniques, we start with the bubble sort, as this one is the simplest method of sorting. It is comparison based algorithm because it compares the elements which are adjacent to each other, and accordingly we supposed to sort the elements. So as I just said, now each pair which are having the adjacent elements that are get compared with each other, and after comparison that adjacent elements exchanges or swaps their position if they are not in order or if it is required. How they exchanges the position, what is swapping, that all the things I am going to explain you very soon in this video series. And that's why the comparison, after the comparison exchange is done between that elements if it is needed, it is called as exchange sort algorithm. And therefore this bubble sort is based on the swapping technique or the exchange technique, and it is the simple one, and that's why it is called as exchange sort algorithm. So what is swapping? Swapping of adjacent elements mean what? So every time we supposed to compare the elements which are present in adjacent positions. So two elements we are going to compare, that's why we have said here like a pair, each pair of the adjacent element is compared, and after comparison what we have to do, the elements are swapped if they are not in order. So we supposed to first of all decide the order, that is if it is ascending order or descending order, and accordingly we have to take a decision. For example, I am showing you, like if this is one single pair is there with me and I want to sort this pair in ascending order, so what I have to do, I have to check or I have to compare both of them. As 32 is less than 52, 32 should be present before the 52 position, so that's why the exchange or the swapping is needed. So for that the swapping will be done like this: 32 will take the position of 52 and 52 will take a position of 32. And now after swapping the pair, the necessary adjustment we have done, and now the numbers are written the order, that is order is ascending order. Now let's see why the bubble is the name given to this particular sorting technique, why the name is bubble sort. So usually the elements tend to move up into the correct order like bubbles rising to the surface. Why? Because they are having the weight as the lighter weight, so the smaller elements which are in the lighter weight, they are bubbles up on the surface, and that's why this is the technique called as bubble sort. So if you must have seen that bubble is having less weight and it takes the position on the surface of the liquid in the same way, the smaller elements usually bubbles up, and the elements which are having the higher weight should get set their position at the end or at the bottom. So that's why this is the sorting technique name is given bubble sort. Now let's see what are the advantages and disadvantages of the bubble sort. So advantages are, the first advantage is it is very simple algorithm. Then only it works on the comparison technique, a simple technique we are going to use, that is nothing but a single task we have to perform here, only the comparison, and if needed we have to swap the elements, and this makes very small and simple program. But what are the disadvantages? So the disadvantages are the time requirement, that is time complexity of this sorting algorithm is very high, because every time it compares the adjacent element and it takes a decision where to swap them or not to swap them, and that's why its time complexity is big O n square, and it is highly inefficient. It is highly inefficient for large data set, and that's why it slows down the sorting method. And why the bubble sort is not as much as good as of the remaining sorting technique, we'll see the reasons one by one. The first reason is, though it is simple, but the time complexity is high, that's why it is very slow, it gives the less performance. If an array is already sorted, then also it goes through the comparison and all the passes required for the execution of this bubble sort. The third reason is why the bubble sort is not that much good is, in all the cases the scenario of the time complexity is big O n square, so it's very inefficient technique is the last reason why the bubble sort is not as good as of the rest of the sorting techniques. So thank you friends for listening and watching this video. If you like the video, please do not forgot to give the comment. Also, if you like the content and the video, do share it with your friends. Do subscribe my channel Tech Talks. Here I am providing you a subscription link, and along with this I am providing you a shortcut link for the next video of this video series, and the whole video series I am going to provide you in the form of playlist. So thank you. Happy data structuring, happy learning. Thank you.